so excited for today's stream, but before we get into that, first, hello, my name is Calamity Darling. I've been making games for about a year now, learning and teaching myself and also taking some courses. We've got ish to do. All right, y'all, you ready to get into this? Change scenes. So we can peek at this little walkthrough. Also, this is Notion. Notion's great. It is called PlayFab. So PlayFab is basically a tool you can use to build games. It's super cool. So we're gonna call this brick block breaker. We are gonna add GitHub. Gonna authorize that real quick. If you're not familiar with GitHub, it's basically a repository where you can like keep your game and then control like each version of it. So as you update it, you can kind of like push each update to the repository. So this is our repository that's going to be connected with this game. Yay, step one is done. So let's get into kind of the meat and bones of creating this game. All right, this is the Unity Hub. This is where we make games. So we're gonna start a new project. We're gonna be building a 2D game. We're going to be calling it Hit the Bricks. So we're gonna add two more scenes. We're going to add, I know we're gonna want a title screen. I want this one to be called Global because all of our other scenes are actually going to go into this. So this is that SDK I was talking about, our software development kit. So this is basically just going to add PlayFab. This is all the PlayFab files. This is going to add it to Unity so we can use it together. The first thing we're actually gonna do is take away the camera because we don't need that for this global scene because it's just gonna hold all the other scenes. We're going to need to reconnect GitHub, but that's fine. We'll do that later. New title. Hit the bricks. Definitely Windows. We'll add more later. Single, multiplayer, eventually create title. Now we are officially linked in PlayFab to the project that we are making now in Unity. We get to start actually working on the game. So the first thing we're going to do is go into the hierarchy, remove the main camera from our little global scene here because we actually don't need it. This is just going to hold, like I said, all of our other scenes. So we're going to go back to assets. We're going to create a scripts folder. We're going to create a C# script and we're going to call it game manager. So this is going to basically manage everything within our game. And now we're gonna open that. We actually do not need any of these things. So we're just gonna get rid of that. We are going to create first function awake. We're going to put don't destroy on load. We got that. We're going to create a new game function. New game. When we start a new game, it's going to go to this function, new game, which we have established right here. Woohoo! So next we are going to add score and lives to our new game function. We want our score to start at 0. So this score, 0 please. And we want our lives to start at 3. Forget load, level, and then for a new game, we're gonna load level 1, right? Load level, so we need to load our level, clearly. This level equals level. All right, so we have that. Yeah, we need to now get our scene manager in here, which is the whole reason we kind of made this game manager in the first place. So it's going to do so much more than just the scene manager. We added our open scenes, which is everything in here that loads in with this global. Call the scenes based on the index here. But for best practice, it is suggested that we do not do that because like I could easily accidentally flip this here and here and now global is no longer 0, global is 2, and then our whole code is messed up. So it is better to call them based on the name of the scene. So going back to our code, we are going to call this based on the name. So for the scenes here, I named them like this very on purpose. So you see how it says like level and then like has a 1 after it? Okay, right here. Load scene level. Now we have the ability to load levels whenever we load level. Now is the fun part, fun with quotation, because this is basically everything we need to get started. We'll go back in here and start adding in like live deduction and scoring and all of that. But for now, this is all we need just because we need to switch between. The main bulk of this is learning to do the login authentication with Twitch, as well as creating the leaderboard. All right, so this is the tedious part, y'all. Now we have to go into this brick prefab. So a prefab is basically, it gives us the ability to copy paste. So a prefab, you can use it to like change everything up once. Like we have this brick prefab here. We are going to add it into our level 1. Every time we change this prefab here, it will change wherever we have put it in the entire game. So we don't have to go in and change it individually. We're gonna add a paddle like here. All right, duplicate. I'm gonna call it row one. I'm going to take all of these and move it. Yeah. All right, how does this look? I think it looks pretty good. This is our game. Oh, you know what we forgot to do? We forgot to change the background. Background, let's make it like a gray. I don't know, there's a lot of different stuff we can do with it. We can look into some changes later for it. Now to figure out how to copy basically this color. Ooh. Okay, so then, yeah, because I made a swatch, I can just kind of go in and like, ba-doop. Oh, I know what we have to do. We have to create material. We can create a material. Let's do it. materials folder. What we can definitely do is go in and make it like red. So we'll call this red brick and we can just drag it. So yeah, for now, we're just going to use this to make them all different colors. But there is ways to like use materials that you can drag on and all that good stuff. Oh, wait, this is supposed to be a different color. What color should this row be? Oh, right. We made the background gray because we don't know what all the colors are going to be. All right. So let's make this row like that purple. This is what we're going with. It's fine. So now we can go in and choose that swatch for all of them. Close enough. What's important is we have first level built. So we got our ball. We got our level basically ready to just add physics to. So this is actually where we're going to be stopping today. I got to play with these colors a little bit to try to figure out colors. This is step one. So to kind of go over what we did, we built our game in PlayFab. We did download the software development kit. We implemented it here into Unity. So we have directly connected our game to PlayFab. This just makes everything a whole lot easier to do that. We added in the ability to do scene changes with the scene manager, but we created this function called new game so that every time we start a new game, you start with 0 score, 3 lives, and you start on level 1. Which we have named all of our scenes to that naming convention, so it is level. And then we have now built base of our game. This is what it looks like in game dev mode. I hope you learned something. I learned a lot. So yeah, because I most certainly did.